Good evening, friends, and we are happy to be back again. Myself, Nagu Chidambaram, and Geeta Nagu, and we are having two more chapters from the book that we will be discussing today during this 20-minute show. It's a 2020 cricket match kind of a situation, and let's enjoy your conversations of the questions, which is making us more knowledgeable by the questions that we receive from you. I would like to request Geeta Nagu to please announce the two topics for the evening, the two chapters of the book.
Yes, the two chapters of the book which we are going to discuss today evening are The Lessons from Kerala, What the Whole World is Looking at. Kerala has become a fantastic case study and we are going to look into that. And also from this COVID situation, how has it improved the viewpoint? After this, how has it improved the viewpoint of us in what are the aspects? So those are the two chapters which is so relevant and what is very interesting too, which we are going to discuss.
Fantastic, Geeta. So one of the few states which started with the infection first in the country was unfortunately Kerala. It had to start somewhere. It had started from Kerala. But the way Kerala reacted, the way the government played the role, the way the NGOs came into place, the way the medical workers came into action is absolutely a lesson for the whole world to understand and learn from. Of course, in India, the other states also are equally competent and they have done a brilliant job because definitely there are states where the population is much, much more higher with a very weak infrastructure. Kerala fortunately has a four-tier health system which came to their rescue, and the 30,000 plus medical workers of the government, they became the strongest volunteers. But let me tell you, friends, the magic that was created by the public in every state of the country. Every citizen of India came together and created a support system for the challenges that were faced. And Kerala led the situation where today, in spite of being the early infected states, the number of people who are recovered are the highest in Kerala. So I think it's a lesson to learn. We have learned a lot from Kerala. All the other states quickly implemented. Fortunately, we were very close to Kerala to understand this and implement it in our own respective states also. Nagu, what's your take on the way Kerala bounced back with this challenge?
Rajesh, this is a crisis. So if you look at the way the crisis has been handled, because crisis does not knock and come, it just knocks you down the way it comes. And this is one such classic case where it just landed where nobody was ever prepared or nobody had any clue of how this was to be handled. And hence, it's only crisis and crisis management. And I think at that, Kerala rebounded very quickly. Everybody's hit on a crisis. How quickly you rebound to a crisis is what is going to really make it or break it. And typically, I think they must have created a war room kind of a situation. And they must have split the team to two. One team would have been thinkers and the other team would have been doers. The thinkers would have been ideate on the what, and the doers would have been figure out on the how. And when they merge together, they start looking at the now and they look at the next. So you've got it really like an army set up. And then when you have a learned population like how it is in Kerala, where people are willing to absorb what it is when it's explained, and then they also start cooperating, like you just said, it's the public that plays the role, you know. And when you understand that social distancing for the first time, when you listen to it, it's like Greek and Latin, though it's English, you start wondering what's the meaning of social distancing. They went on to hold to it like dear life, and the results are obviously magic. I think everybody's heard about the umbrella story that they came out with. It's just simple thought to apply, and therefore you do it. And that has given massive results. If you look at the way they have protected the drivers, the cab drivers, now they could get equally hit or infected, affected. And the way they've created that slim thing, it's like what you see in London, the cabs. There is a partition between the driver and the passenger. You think it's only London. It's not the case. Where there is a need, you go and set it up. And here they've set it up so beautifully, elegantly, and it's giving results. And they come up with multiple such small things, which I'm sure every state is looking at. Every state has looked at and done the same or more. Maybe this was marketed well, and it at least caught the attention of everybody. Nevertheless, I think Kerala is shining and it's showing from the front how it can be handled. I think it's fantastic. A great deal what they have done.
Fantastic. So, Surya Chidambaram, do you think Kerala's magic will be a case study at Harvard level and everybody worldwide will be able to learn? For sure, Surya, even other parts of the country have learned it and the world is looking towards it as a model. But let me tell you one interesting aspect. The learnings came out of the previous pandemic that Kerala handled, and that learning was helpful in these current times, and they used technology to the T. The war room that Nagu spoke about was absolutely a call center. It was absolutely a military kind of an operation where all the government agencies swung to the absolute immediate action. 1,200 people managing the call centers, and they classified the entire population into three categories. The category of the first category was the people who needed medical services and support system. The second category was the people who needed food to live, to sustain. And the third category was they also started creating psychological setups where psychological and psychiatrists and psychological doctors were available on the phone to console people who were scared out of their wits. So all those three actions happened simultaneously at the same time, and it was a well-prepared plan. Fortunately for Kerala, their village system is absolutely in place, and the Gram Panchayat also played a very critical role. And this is what exactly is being done by every Gram Panchayat in India. They are absolutely on the last rung of the population. They are connected with people and treating them, motivating them and helping them to understand the importance, the necessities and the procedures of social distancing, which is helping to avoid the spread of this dangerous disease. Geeta, your take on the next question that I would put to you.
We will discuss about Kerala. We will just
that population matters. Is this result of education strength from Mr. Vinod Parker?
Absolutely, it is the result of education. Kerala has the highest literacy, and it has the because of that so many things. Very robust public healthcare system. Actually, if you look at it, the risk of transmission is the greatest in Kerala because the huge population which is living abroad is in Kerala. They have the highest remittance money coming to India. So, huge number of people are living abroad, as well as highest tourism crowd is also happening in Kerala. With both of this, they have the greatest risk of transmission, but they have flattened the curve. This is a fantastic case study, and the first credit always goes to the literacy rate. It is the education which is going to solve all the problems. It is the awareness. When the awareness goes to the people who are educated, they are going to incorporate it. You don't have to put force. What is happening in other states is we have to, for the civilians to adhere to the norms, we have to put force. But whereas in Kerala, that never happened. Why? Education was playing the part. Kerala could become a very good model for our other states to, you know, follow up. And that is the structure we should be looking at. Their follow through, their awareness, how the government and the public came together, how the NGOs and the health workers worked together, and how the communication system was, how the helpline and mental helpline systems and their tracking, their tracing, everything was fantastic, and how they used their resources. This situation, India has used the resources very well, right from the railway coaches to Kerala, where Nagu was saying about the taxi, and then you said about the umbrella. All that is being very resourceful and innovative and creative in your solutions. This is what we as individuals and professionals, as organizations have to learn, that anything can be crossed over if we are being very resourceful about it. We are very innovative about it. We are very creative about the solutions. We don't have to wait for one high funda solution to come and solve. It is just all around us. So if you're looking at that need, then it could be easily solved.
Fantastic. Thank you, Geeta. That's awesome. Mr. Unmesh Patil is a member of parliament from Maharashtra, very young and a very dynamic and extraordinarily qualified member of parliament. India needs people like the Mr. Unmesh Patil. And his point is literacy and techno-savvy state. Yes, Mr. Patil, it is absolutely one of the most literate states of India. We are very proud about it. And at the same time, technology was used to the T to make sure that there is rescue and relief to the people in need. Actually, they used the facilities of all the possible Google tools to the highest. And every government organization team and every donor team, supporter team, NGO team, everybody uses technology to the T. And that has been a great breather for creating the reprieve that we have seen. And the results are so fantastic, where the ratio of the people recovered is the highest, one of the highest, not only in the country, but majority of the parts of the world. Next question is from Rohit Rahul. India has so much diversity and conditions are different everywhere. So is it really possible to follow Kerala model? Your take on that, Nagu.
Rohit, see, here's what it is. Now, Kerala has a model. Kerala does not have a model which is exclusive to itself. Kerala said, let's respond to a situation. Rather than reacting, let's respond. So the difference is reacting, you immediately jump. Responses, you think and you jump. Here, they've thought, they've jumped, and they've jumped immediately at it. So if we can adopt this practice, policy, principle. Let us then say, let's indigenize it to suit that particular state, that atmosphere. Now, what's done in Kerala might be done, might be doable in Munnar. Is it doable in Ooty? Is it doable in Kanyakumari, Delhi? You'll have to look at it. But what they have done is not exclusive to their space alone. They have done it. Now, let's do that and let's look at others that we can do on similar lines, different lines. Basically, respond to a situation immediately. One of Kerala's biggest take was, let's do it immediately and track it. Because when the numbers are small, the tracking and control is easy. When the numbers go big, the same amount of tracking will get tired. The system will get weak purely because the numbers have expanded. So that's the whole thing.
Fantastic. Thank you, Nagu. Sandeep Pote is the logistics business. How much time Mumbai will take to control Corona and what Kerala did, which Mumbai can't replicate? So Sandeep, everything that Kerala has done has been replicated by the whole country. Whatever Mumbai is doing, Chennai is doing, or other states of the other cities of the country are doing is being replicated by every place in the city, every city in the country. Apart from that, what is critically important is, because of this crisis, we have learned a new concept which everybody is executing and implementing, which is not corporate social responsibility alone. That is, all the corporates have really come together and supported this situation currently. But what is more critically important, which we witness every day, is the personal social responsibility. There is amazing support from every citizen of India to every city and village of the country to ensure that citizen suffers, goes home hungry, sleeps hungry, or is having a lack of medical facility. Everybody is trying to do their best to make sure that the whole country is together and as one single family trying to tide over this current crisis. Your take on that, Geeta?
Yes, that is so true, Rajesh. And what we are able to understand out of this is only the quick response time, which individually and proactively each state, each country has done. And whichever country has done the quick response time, we have come out of it. India had a quick response time to this. Kerala had a very quick response time. So that is proactive management, which is very, very important. What we learn out of this crisis is everybody has to have two P's, which is precaution and positivity. Precaution is to the level of being paranoid. You should be so precautious that to the level of being so paranoid, at the same time, it is polarity, two polarities. You need to be extremely positive, because the medication and what is going to take us forward is not the fear, but it is positivity. But with that positivity should not lead to overconfidence. It has to be with utmost caution, precaution, and to the level of your paranoid. So that being paranoid and extremely positive is the two extreme things what I have learned out of the whole thing. And another very important thing which has evolved out of it is the crisis management. In the crisis management, when you're looking at states, when you're looking at countries, when you're looking at companies, when you're looking at professionals, when you're looking at individuals, everybody is going through this crisis management in their own ways. So what is making some states or countries come out of it, or some individuals and companies come out of it effectively, is two things. One is they reserve what they build. And the second, that is very, very important. That is what we learn out of this crisis, which we need to, from now onwards, we should all become crisis proof. If we have to become crisis proof, we need to build a reserve individually, professionally, company wise, everybody, state wise, you know, your government wise, everything. That reserve has to be built for a crisis. And number two is your competitiveness has to be built. If it is a company, your competitiveness has to be built. If it is you are a professional, then your skill has to be built. Your skill is very important. Your delivery is very important. As well as when you're a company, your competitiveness is very important. On normal times, you have to build on your competitiveness. You have to build on your efficiency and you have to build on your reserve. Those are the only things which is going to be crisis proof. And that is what will help you during crisis to manage. If Kerala has managed this, they have gone through earlier calamities like this. Right. So that earlier experience has built that competitiveness in them. That earlier experience has built that reserve
efficiency
in them. So that Perfect. Is what is the whole thing.
Perfect. So the attitude of gratitude, attitude and gratitude will play a very critical role. When you express gratitude to somebody, that somebody gets motivated to not only support you, but more people like you if you are in times of need. So the attitude of gratitude is absolutely critically to understand in the current times. And now we move to our next topic. And the next topic is the worldview of the current scenario, especially the world view of the current scenario and also India's view on this current scenario. So friends, we are moving in a very fast-paced change environment, and for this to change, we need to adapt our mindset to the new norm, which has become a new world order. And that preparedness is very critically important, because now it is not only the question of the life, but also livelihood. Very soon, we will develop the herd immunity, which will make sure that we sustain and survive through this corona crisis. Unless and until this medicine or the medication or vaccine is not created, and that would follow in the next few days or a few months to come. But we need to come out and also lift up the economy to a great extent. So we need to be precautious. We need to follow the government instructions. At the same time, we should be aware that we are the builders of the economy, all of us put together. So we need to discharge our responsibility as well. Government has also already relaxed in majority parts of the country, where 33% of the people can go to work every day, and they need to maintain social distancing. With keeping those norms in mind, all of us need to become productive back again, and we need to live with the corona, and we need to live around the corona. Precautionary living is better than any cure. So I think we need to move forward. Milind, how India is emerging as a world leader during COVID-19 pandemic, how India is supporting the world. Nagu, your take on this.
No, India has learned quite a bit. India is leading from the front because they're really delivering. For a large nation like us, where we have our own set of challenges, I think we have shown the world what we are capable of and how, as a nation, we stick together and we're able to deliver what's required. The call of the order has been really well taken, right from our PM, right, going through and through and through to whomever you know, you don't know. Everybody has played their part to the T, and therefore the result. So today, if we're talking about, there are some cases coming up here, coming up there, it can be controlled. Correct. After all of these steps, the virus is a virus, and that's why it's called a virus, and that's why we've gone in for a lockdown. So that is going to be there. That does not take away anything of what the state and the country has done. And surely it has shown the world what we are capable of. Now, obviously, this throws a lot of things. It throws a lot of things in terms of the mind of an entrepreneur, in terms of people in other countries of, oh, wow, India can deliver. So it's not that if you don't know what to do, if you don't know where else to go, then go to India and get parts. No, nothing. India can deliver. Then look at India as a sustainable option in any of your requirements. And that's going to lead to an all-around growth in infrastructure. That's so important for the country. It's so important for every individual, every person of the country, whether he's a business owner or he's a bureaucrat or he's employed somewhere. It's very important because this is going to throw a whole load of opportunities up, and that's where we're all going to benefit. So the whole thing is, let's look at the positivity out of this situation, what all it throws up. Our preparedness is very important. Now, as business owners, when we step into our premises after a 45-day lockdown, the first thing to say is, friends, let's protect ourselves, let's protect our family, let's protect our organization, and let's not say, will somebody protect me? Do you want to take that responsibility onto you first? If the answer is yes, then I think we're firing on all cylinders. And that's what we are all doing, and it's great to see it all around, and that's where India is on top.
Fabulous, fabulous. That's the reason why India will play a leadership role in the world. And what we need today is leadership, not only leadership at the country level, but also leadership on the level of the family and the organization. Every person has to play a leader's role, and that is the demand of the time. Monisha Umesh has a last question that we'll address. What are the views of this COVID crisis to understand and take it further? Is it forward or re-forward or pause? Monisha, in life, there is nothing which is called as a pause. You need to move forward. If you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, crawl. But whatever you do, it needs to be positioned. If you fall, fall forward. So there is nothing called pause in our life, and we will always keep moving forward in all aspects. We are together. The country is together. The people are together. The teams are together. The resources are together. We don't need anything else. It is just a matter of time. All this too shall pass absolutely comfortably, and that is the confidence that we have. So leadership at the country level, leadership at the organization level, leadership at the family level, and also you need to be your own leader. You need to define and decide the actions that you are going to take, which is going to add value to the lives of the people around you, who are directly connected and indirectly connected with you at all times. So it is a leadership demand situation. And if you are that leader, fantastic. If you are not, take other leaders on board who can guide you and tide you through this particular period of crisis. I wish you all the best. Have a God-blessed evening, and I will see you again tomorrow in the evening at 4:15 p.m. Bye for now. This is Agnello Rajesh.
India is a land of resilience and determination. Several prehistoric times, we have gone through several things and we've come out with flying colors. This is yet another situation. We will all do fantastically well. Lockdown is now opened and the economy has to go on. Life has to go on, and we are all moving ahead with the same resilience and determination. We all together, with personal leadership, with professional leadership, organizational leadership, and our country's leadership, we are going to be shining. And it is a fantastic, in this adversity, this is India's best opportunity. At the same time, India is very humane and we are supporting other nations. We are the pharmacy of the world and we will help everybody around. Meanwhile, we are also going to have fantastic growth opportunities. So let us all look forward and march forward. Signing off, and see you tomorrow, Geeta Nagu.
Thank you so much, Geeta. Yes, Nagu.
Hi, everybody. That was wonderful chatting up. Now, I just have one point to state. Please don't sing a negative tune because your neighbor or whomever else you know is talking about it. Instead, you turn it around by speaking about something positive. Look about the opportunities that are available. If somebody's got a pain, see how you can cure it. Then see how you can fix it in the long term. If it can be turned into a business opportunity, it's going to be great. It could be a product or a service. So keep looking for opportunities, because a business opportunity for you is curing the pain of somebody else. And therefore, everything from here is only growth and upward movement. And see you all tomorrow evening at 4:15. This is Nagu Chidambaram signing off.
Fantastic.
Bye.
Fantastic, Nagu. The virus is contagious enough. Let us not have contagiousness from negativity. Let us have positivity all around us. Have a God-blessed evening. Thank you.